Welcome to Planet Mojo. This is part two of the Dozer Work Exploration. I hate when a cat does that. That is way the hell down there. I don't know if you can see how far down that is. But she's on this mossy branch, and there's no talking to cats about doing dangerous stuff. Come on, kitty, let's go down the hill. Izzy's already way the hell down there. Oh my. This was so degraded that in places the gator would just barely, the gator's only 5 feet wide, and the gator was like getting crowded trying to come up this. I haven't come up it in, oh, probably the first year that we got the gator. I haven't tried it anymore because it was so damn dangerous. It was at an angle like that. There was huge ruts. There was big rocks. And I smacked a big rock coming up it. There was nothing I could do. You know, once you start coming up this, you have to kind of gun it and get your butt up. So stuff in the way, you can't really stop and roll a rock out of the way. And it's very far down to the bottom there. Man, this is wide as hell. This is like a super highway coming through here. There's one water bar here that hardly seems like enough, but you know, when I'm talking to the DNR lady, she was talking about, you know, you should put 3 water bars here and 2 water bars there. And, you know, this is 1 water bar on this whole hill so far. And what a water bar does is when the water starts flowing down the hill, it catches it and pushes it off to the side so that it doesn't ruin your road. It looks like there used to be one right here as well. Yeah, hard to tell. Kitty. Kitty cat. Okay, let's do this. Yeah, don't look anywhere near as scary as it used to be. What he did was, you know, it's rip and flip. You take dirt from this side and push it over to this side. So what was real steep this way is now fairly level. Hopefully this drains and doesn't just run right down the road. Kind of hard to tell how steep this is, but it's pretty damn steep. The trees are just huge down here, so it's like it's a really cool place. Yeah, and the road gets steeper here. All right, here's another water bar. So there's at least 2. That's good. Maybe these are the only 2 that were here before. Just don't know. I haven't been around here in quite a while. Our son got lost, oh, ages ago. He was still pretty young. And he was going to come around this. It's like a mile. If you go out our back door and walk around this big loop, it's about a mile. And he ended up on the other side of the hollow on the highway, way over that way. He got lost pretty bad, got turned around down here. It was pretty thick and pretty unmarked back then. Now that we've been here and using the trails and clearing them and stuff, you can actually see where the roads are. And back then, it was kind of hard to see. So this is another water bar right here. Now this should shoot the water. Yeah, and he put a V-groove in it and took it over to the ravine over here. So that's good. This will just kind of wash in and it'll connect right there. So yeah, it does look like he restored the water bars that were here. Good news. That's the bottom down there. Let's go take a look. Well, hopefully, yeah, here's one of them boulders. I mean, this is all rock. It's dirt on top of rock. So whenever you doze or anything, you can see right there, or when it erodes, the rocks come out. And that's the way this hill was. It had a bunch of boulders like these in the middle of the road the last time I went up it, and it was one hell of a scary ride. And when my nephew went up it very recently, and he said that it was pretty nasty. So yeah, this just pushed some stuff in there. There is actually a road that's kind of disappearing back in that way. You can see it in the fall. But in the summertime, it pretty much disappears. Looks like he was pushing something here. You can see this, like a boulder or something. Wow. I had to cut a bunch of trees. Those might have been cut earlier. The neighbor at the end of the road here collects wood down here. So, and then you actually go on to that neighbor at the end of the road's land, starts right over there. But it looks like he cleared. Oh, I don't think he went. Yeah, he stopped right here, it looks like. Maybe. Well, let's just take a quick look. This right here, that's a walnut stump. So the road used to be right over there a bit, because these were right at the edge of the road. They had these logged out. Like three or four trees. They were giant walnuts that looked like that one I showed you in the last video. Probably about the same size. And you get about $1,000 a piece for them as veneer logs. The Chinese are going through an opulence phase, kind of like we did in the 50s with, you know, walnut paneling and all that stuff. Okay, that's it right here. You could see it just pushed up right there. This is probably the lot line right in here.
Izzy, come!
Good girl. Okay. I'm actually watching Izzy. My daughter went on vacation. Natalie went on vacation. So I need to bring her with me pretty much everywhere I go for a week or whatever, 4 days, 5 days, whatever it is. I'm not that great with schedules. Maisie May, let's go, honey. She may not know this area, so I don't want to, you know, just turn around and leave her down here. Usually she follows, but if she starts hunting, you know, she could turn around and I'm gone and not know how to get back to the house. Not likely that we'd lose her, but I don't want to take the chance. She goes all over this property, so she would probably find her way back, but not worth the chance. This is where that last logging road kind of goes down that way. And I really don't know how it connects. Like I said, there is kind of like a switchback in there. Yeah, they got a real nice chunk of property here. And now that they got this road usable, now they can get down here and enjoy some of this stuff. You know, clear this road down here, and then they can actually drive their... It's not a Gator, but it's a Honda something. think he calls it a goat, but I'm not really sure what it is. Okay, come on, Maisie May. Pretty awesome stuff. All right, I'm gonna hike my butt back up this hill and I will check back in with you up by the top. Yeah, I'm about halfway up here. So, reassessing this road, I think this is pretty damn nice. I mean, he redid the water bars right where they were, and they're probably as good as it's gonna get. You just can't wear these damn things down. If you put tire tracks through them when it's wet, water just goes right through them tire tracks, and then it already has speed, comes down, goes through them tire tracks, and next thing you know, the road's gone. So every certain distance, you need to stop the water and get rid of it. I have to excuse my GoPro crashes, but I was saying, every certain distance you need to divert the water and get it off the road so you don't have a whole bunch of water moving real fast down your road, which equals erosion. Okay, I stopped here because I heard him come back, the guy, the contractor, bulldozer guy. I think he's still up there. I can't tell if he drove back out or not. The road runs along the, I don't know if you can see that edge up there. So he might be coming down here with the dozer. I think he's done with this, but who knows. Across there, you can see where that water I pointed out earlier, that's where it's connecting back over with this. So yeah, they really need a couple pipes in that road. I don't know if the contractor knows about that water crossing right there, or if they asked him to put pipes in, but really needs it. Okay. Again, I will check in a little bit up further. We might just go up our road and go into the west pasture and check that out. I'm in the west pasture here. Natalie cut this 2 days ago. I believe that's what it was. And she said she cut a little trail down into the lower part. And then on the way back up, she got the blade jammed. And it looks like this is what she was hitting. She just went through all this stuff. So it was probably a piece of this. So that explains that. Yeah, if she had that monster machine that the neighbors let us borrow, it would have just went right through this, but not a regular old zero turn. But I'm looking through here, and this is all garlic mustard. This is 1 year garlic mustard. So, I don't know. I really don't want to mess around with this stuff this year. I just don't have the time. All the other projects are taking precedence. These are, hi Kitty, these are rosettes, so these aren't going to do much of anything until next year. Then the full-sized ones will pop up. Oh, where'd that go? There's a bull thistle right over here that's, you know, it's like that tall. Another thing that has rosettes the first year and then a full-sized plant the next year. So I'll have to get down here early next year. We're gonna have to clean out all this wood again. A lot of this stuff, you can see the girdle marks on these trees. Where's another one? Yeah, I girdled a whole bunch of these a couple years back, and they keep losing their top branches because they're really rotten. I am so surprised they haven't fallen down. You know, we had 50 mile an hour winds just 3 days ago, something like that. And these are really, really, how would I put that? They're not strong trees, the aspen. They get real punky real quick. So I'm sure that tree's rotten on the inside. You can see all the fungus on it. Don't know why it hasn't fallen yet. So, yeah, I'll have a garlic mustard problem over here. But anyway, wrapping up the bulldozing, it looks really nice in there. They had a lot of work done. I wish we could do that this year, but it's looking like we're not going to be able to afford it right now. We do everything with cash, or nearly everything with cash, so as soon as we have the money, we got to fix our road as well. Yeah, when you keep buying land like we did, it saps a lot of money, but gives you a lot of room to move around. I would hate to have neighbors right here and neighbors right there, and that would just totally suck. Okay, here he comes out of the woods. He's taking his tools out of there, his machines. So, I guess I'm going to wrap this up right now. If you have any questions or comments on anything that's going on here at the homestead, make sure you put them in the comments below. If you want to see the day-to-day stuff going on here, make sure you subscribe and then click on the update icon so you receive notice when I post new videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.